Jim, a milestone in your career tonight, 1,000 pro games. Can you take us back to the start and tell us about your early memories of getting the chance to play pro?
Yeah, that's a long time back, but you know, I was fortunate enough to sign with the Philadelphia Flyers at a junior and started the season, my first year pro with the Phantoms in Philly. Played in the old Spectrum. It was pretty cool. I got to play with my older brother. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. And then second year, actually, I called up New Year's Eve, actually, and played on the third in Anaheim, and that was probably the best game, most memorable game ever.
And, you know, experience like playing with your brother in a pro sport in North America, there's not many people get the chance to do that. That must have been a special moment.
Oh, it was great. You know, there was a chance I was actually going to play with three of them the year before. They were all playing in the East Coast Hockey League, and they'd asked me to come down there, but I got some advice not to do that, and then the next year I played back in junior and ended up signing an NHL contract out of it, so it worked out good for me.
461 games in the NHL, over 200 in the AHL, representing your country, Team Canada, in the Spengler Cup twice, and obviously, you know, playing over Europe as well, ending up in Belfast. You know, you've picked up a trophy along the way in Belfast as well. Is there any memorable games that stick out to you apart from your first NHL game, which is obviously probably one of your major highlights?
Yeah, I think, you know, after playing that many, they kind of blend in. But, you know, here and there, it'd be hard to pick out anything specific. But, you know, there's always, you know, 20 guys, 24 guys on a team that you bond with over the year. And, you know, I've played for a lot of different teams, so there's a lot of different guys. But, you know, it's just been great. You know, lots of guys, lots of people, lots of cool cities that I've, you know, lived in. So it's been a good ride.
And, you know, growing up in Canada, national sport, every kid's dream is to play in the NHL. You wouldn't have been able to do that without the support of your family and friends and obviously your parents as well.
No, absolutely. That's, you know, if it wasn't, you know, for my dad getting, you know, a couple of my older brothers playing hockey, you know, I probably wouldn't have got into it either, you know. I'm the fourth of six boys, so, you know, you just want to do what your older brothers are doing, and, you know, they give you a push on the way, they push you down, but then they pull you up, and, you know, if it wasn't for those, you know, those learning, those teaching moments from those guys, you know, making you stronger mentally, probably wouldn't have been there.
1,000 games tonight, the Belfast crowd showed your appreciation, obviously with a short video being shown of some of your highlights of your career. And again, it's obviously something special to put in the memory bank.
No, for sure. I was hoping there'd be some more goals on there, but maybe I didn't score enough, or they were so long ago the video wasn't very good. But it was great. You know, they paused the face off there for a bit in the video, and you know, a good cheer from the crowd for longer than I expected. So, you know, it was definitely you know, really cool experience.
You're in a very good position league wise with the Belfast Giants so far. Finals of Continental Cup in 2 weeks' time, three games and three wins, and you're champions of that. Challenge Cup, playoffs, what's left for the rest of the season for you and your teammates in the Belfast Giants?
You know, we want it all. You know, that's the plan, that's the goal. You know, we'll take it one game at a time, but like you said, all those things you mentioned, that's what we're going for, all of them.